A very good morning. Now let us see a topic, heap data structure. Heap data structure is like a binary search tree which follows two properties. One is structure property, the other one is heap order property. Coming to the first one, talking about the structure property, that has to be followed for the heap is, heap is like a complete binary tree. It is like a complete binary tree. Which fills its nodes, in which the nodes are filled from left to right direction. And this complete filling property, it can be accepted with the bottom level. Okay, so what is the structure property is that it is like a binary tree first of all basically. Then it should follow complete binary tree, and the definition of complete binary tree, it is telling us that at every level all the nodes should be filled except the bottom level. In the bottom level there can be some spaces left empty, not filled with any data, and at each level filling of the nodes that should happen from left to right direction. And if these things are followed, we can say that heap structure property is satisfied. Let us see an example of, so one is some root node and the next node to be added is in the next level. This level is filled, so next level we have to fill 5, and here we can insert second. Now the second level is filled, then we have to go for the third level, then we can fill it like this. Here even the nodes are not filled for as the childs of the 6, this is satisfying the structure property of a heap because it is like a complete binary tree and it is except bottom and left to right direction. This is about the heap structure property. Then the second one, heap order property. This heap order property, by applying this heap order property, what is the advantage we'll get is, to discuss that, let us take binary search tree. We have already seen the properties and all of the binary search tree, and with binary search tree, if you are considering the operations find min and find max, find min and find max, we have already seen that to get the min we have to traverse the tree to its leftmost. The leftmost node of the tree has to be accessed. For accessing leftmost of the tree, we need to access all the height of the tree, all the height of the tree, and for finding max it is the rightmost node we have to traverse. And we have already observed that to find min and max, which is nothing but leftmost and rightmost node of the tree, it is taking the time complexity, either order of height of the tree has to be accessed or order of log n, wherein this n is representing the number of nodes in the tree. So this we have seen with the binary search tree, but here by applying this heap order property, now we want to reduce this time complexity, which is taken for find min and find max, to order of 1. So how it is possible by defining the heap order property, we'll see. And here our goal is to get the time complexity for find min and find max as order of 1 unit of time complexity. How it is possible to get minimum value from a list of values which are stored as a binary search tree? It is simply clear that the node or the minimum key value should be there in the root node, or the maximum key value should be there at the root level. Then we can observe that it is giving time complexity of 1. So now it is possible by defining heap order property to place the minimum value among all the list of values for which you have to construct the heap to be placed at the root level, that is your min heap will hold the minimum value among all the list of values placed at the root, and max heap is that the maximum value among all the list of values is placed at the root. To maintain this, actually to achieve that, the heap order property for minimum heap is defined as, for each node x, if you consider its left child and right child, both needs to have a larger value than x. Its left child and right child both needs to have a max value, a larger value than x. It is something like, if you are considering the node x, its left and right both should have larger values to the node considered, and this property has to be satisfied for every node of the heap, then it will be called as min heap. Here if you can observe this, if you consider 7 node, that is 9 and 10, both are having max, and for 9 also if you consider their children, they should be 11 and 13 like this, because it is minimum heap at every level node, at every node level. Here also if you consider, its parent should have lesser value than its both the children, and here also if you consider, the parent should have lesser value than both of its children. This is an example for min heap. Okay, and as we have already quoted that it is following the properties of complete binary tree, and that numbering also it follows in left to right direction, that numbering should be given, and the root node will be at the number 1, and once a level is completed we have to go for the next level. So it is 2 3 4 5 6 7, and even it is possible, even you don't have these nodes here, the children of this 10, if it is not having any children, now this is also a valid heap, because we have already discussed it should satisfy complete binary tree, which is indicating the bottom level can be something like it may have some empty locations. Here 2 empty locations are there, even then this is a min heap. And based on this numbering given, whatever the maximum number given to a particular node, that indicates number of nodes in the heap also. This 5 is indicating number of nodes as 5. Here this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 nodes. Okay. So this is all about min heap. Coming to max heap is that, and for each node x, its left child and right child should have lesser values than x. Something like, if you consider x as 15, its left and right both should have lesser values. So they should be taken something like 12 and 13. Yes, this is a heap. 1, 2, 3. Next, which level to be, which node, which position to be linked with a node? This one. Here we'll get, and its left child should have lesser value to it. So it can be 11. And its right child also should have lesser value to it, and it is 10. Okay, and the numbering here, that this is 4, this is 5, like this. And from the minimum heap, by observing this, we can see that the minimum value among all the list of values, we are having it at the root node. And from the max heap, we are able to get the maximum value from the root node. So with this, we could achieve time complexity as order of 1 for finding the min and finding the max. This is about the heap order property. Now, let us see the process of constructing or creation of a heap. Following both the properties, structure property and heap order property. It is creation of a heap or construction of a heap. This creating a heap or constructing a heap from the given list of values, it is possible in two ways. The first way is that first construct the taking the list of values. First, let us construct a complete binary tree. Then you have to check for heap order property, whether it is satisfied or not from the bottom level to the root. You have to check for the heap order property. That is first way. It is construct complete binary tree, then check for heap order property from the bottom level to root. This is the first way of constructing a heap. And the second way of constructing heap is by adding one node to the heap data structure. At each insertion you have to check whether it is satisfying the heap order property or not. If it is satisfying, we have to go for the next node insertion. If it is not satisfying, we have to manipulate, we have to do some swap or exchange operations there to convert that non-heap to heap, and then you have to continue for inserting the other nodes. Okay, so it is second method is saying insert each node and check for heap order property. Okay, this is the second method. Now let us take a list of values and we'll see construction of the heap. First applying the first method, then applying the second method. Let us take the list of values. For construction of heap, 12, 15, 8, 7, 6, 2. Let us take 6 values here and let's construct min heap. Okay, so let's start with the first node and following the first procedure. First of all, we have to construct the binary tree. So let us take the first node 12, that will become the root node, and it is placed at the position 1. And next node, it is 15, it will be added as its left child and its position is 2. Then its right is 8 and its position is 3. Then 7 is added here, 6 is added here, and 2 is added here, and the positions are 4, 5, 6 like this. And our min heap property is that every parent should have less value than its left and right childs. Okay, now let us check this heap order property from the leaf level to up. and here every parent, here the parent is 15, every parent should have lesser value than its children, but here it is not satisfying, so we have to send the minimum among these two to its parent. The minimum among these two, if you compare these to, the minimum among is 6, so 6 we have to swap here. So 6 will come here and 15 will come here. Now the parent is having lesser value than its both the child. Coming over here, parent is 8 and the child is 2. No, it is not satisfying the heap order property. Let us swap these two. So 8 will come here and 2 will come here. Now to the next level, here parent is 12 and parent should have lesser value than its children, but it is not satisfying here. So among these two children of it, which is minimum? 2 is the minimum. So 2 should be swapped with that. So we'll get, this will be 12 and this will be 2. Now at the parent level, at the root level, yes, this is having lesser value than its children. And at this level, this node is having lesser value than its children. And this node, no. Here again it is not satisfying. It should have lesser value than its children. So again here, it should be swapped. We'll get 8 here and we'll get 12 here. Yes, now everything is, we achieved. At every level, parent is having lesser value than its child. So this is the heap, min heap we have constructed with the list of values following the first procedure. Now let us follow the second procedure. What is our second procedure? At each level, check for the heap order property. Now initially the first node is added as usual 12. Then for adding 15 as it's left, it should follow heap order property. Heap order property is that parent should have lesser value than its child. Yes, it is satisfied. So the second insertion also happened successfully. Then let us go for the third insertion, 12, 15, and here it is 8. And while adding this 8, it is violating the heap order property. As here it is violating the heap order property, here we have to make a comparison and we have to send this lesser value to the higher level. So now it is satisfying the heap order property. Now 7 is added here. Now here 7 minimum value is added. Is it satisfying heap order property? No, it is not satisfying, so we have to swap 15 and 7. By doing this again, here is it satisfying heap order property? No, it is not satisfying. The minimum we have to send up, so it is 7, 8. Now is at every level, is it satisfying heap order property? Yes. Now adding the next value, 4 values we have added. 6. So by adding a 6 here, is it satisfying heap order property? No. So we have to exchange. So 8 will come here and 6 will come here. Now is it satisfying heap order property at this level? No. So again we have to go for, now is it satisfying heap order property? Yes. Here it is satisfying. Here also it is satisfying. Now by adding 2 here, 2, is it satisfying heap order property? No, here it is not satisfying. So here we have to change. 12 will come here and 2 will come here. Here at this level, is it satisfying? No, here this level also it is not satisfying. So 2 will come here and 6 will come here. Now is it satisfying at every level? Yes, here if it is parent, yes, it is having minimum value than its children. Here this is parent, it is having lesser value than its children. And here this is the parent, it is having lesser value than its children. Now this is our min heap. And the root node value, if you observe, it is the minimum value among all the list of values. Now upon this heap, by performing one delete operation, will return us the minimum value. Now here, there if you observe these two methods, we have to get the same heap. Both the methods we can apply to get the same heap. So this is all about construction of heap data structure by following two different ways. Thank you.